Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ikeda.
Hello friends, I welcome you all to this video. This video is the fourth video from the first chapter of the subject Digital Image Processing. In this video, the topic Fundamental Steps in Digital Image Processing, where the chapter introduces the entire depth and all the things related to digital image processing. Up till now in this chapter, we have gone through the first topic, what exactly digital image processing is meant, the digital images and the further processing we have seen. Afterwards, the origins of digital image processing, the historical perspective we have seen, followed by the third topic, that is applications of digital image processing, where the applications were categorized based on to the source of imaging. So the energy spectrum we have taken for the energy with respect to the per unit photon, along with certain more examples of the ultrasound and acoustic imaging. So in this fundamental steps of digital image processing, the further chapters that we are going to address is introduced here. These are actually the terms into the digital image processing, that are image enhancement, image restoration, image compression, wavelets and multi-resolution analysis, along with the morphological image processing and the object recognition. So let us see the topic fundamental steps into the digital image processing. So let us start with the topic from the first chapter, that is fundamental steps into the digital image processing here. So digital image processing, I hope you are having a broad idea what exactly we have to do into this particular subject. So the title, fundamental steps into the digital image processing, the very first topic to address the fundamental steps, we can have the point that it is helpful to divide the material of digital image processing into the two broad categories. The categories can be given, the first category that involve the methods whose input and output are the images, and the second category that is the methods whose inputs may be images but whose outputs are the attributes extracted from those images. In one of the previous lecture, that is the first lecture, what is digital image processing? Sometime we try to define the digital image processing, that is the digital images are processed by digital computer, the input and output both are images. But we have also seen that it is a limiting definition. Therefore, whether the output is in the form of image or the attribute information is all belonging to the digital image processing. But based on to such two criteria, we can have the proper categorization, and we shall see the fundamental steps here. So we can begin very first of all with the knowledge base, which we can have the information of everything related to all such steps here. The very first step is image acquisition. As we know that for processing of the digital image, we require first of all the image. So capturing the image, recording the image is called as the image acquisition. So this is the very first fundamental step into the digital image processing, that is image acquisition. After image acquisition, whatever the raw image is captured, that we can have the filtering and more enhancement to improve the pictorial and information content of the image. So image filtering and the enhancement can be the second fundamental step into the digital image processing. The third one is image restoration. Image restoration is also meant for the betterment of the information content into the image. Whatever the blurred images may be there, the blurred can be removed by the image restoration techniques. The example I can share here. So the image restoration is the third fundamental step into digital image processing, followed by the fourth one, that is color image processing. So these three can address to the gray level images we shall begin initially into our subject, into the subsequent chapters, and further we shall move to the color image processing. The color image processing is followed by the wavelets and the multi-resolution processing. After Fourier, we know that wavelet is a very potential tool that has given a lot of applications with the preciseness and the accuracy into the image processing, and it works with the multi-resolution analysis or multi-resolution processing, we can say. The image information at one resolution can be at another, cannot be at another resolution. So obtaining the information at multiple resolutions is the basic idea behind this particular processing. So first one is image acquisition, second one is image filtering and enhancement, third one is image restoration, fourth one is color image processing, fifth one is wavelets and multi-resolution processing. The sixth fundamental step is the compression. Image compression is the sixth fundamental step, where the memory requirement for storage and further for the transmission of the image data from one place to another place is to be minimized by the compression techniques. The very familiar image type that we have, JPEG image, is image compression technique basically. The next fundamental step is morphological processing. Morphology basically deals with the shape. So morphological processing techniques are there into the image processing to have certain applications addressed. It is also followed by the segmentation, then representation and description, and finally the object recognition. So to discuss with the fundamental steps of image processing, we extend from first of all acquiring the image into this step, that is image acquisition. And finally, after these much of several fundamental steps, we recognize the objects associated into that particular image data. So one by one we can address here the classification what we have made, that is the methods whose input and output are images, and the methods whose inputs may be images and the outputs may be attributes, that we can address here. So right from image acquisition to morphological processing, the first category that we have addressed can be said, and from morphological image processing to the object recognition, the second category can be addressed here. So here the more clear classification, block 1 to 7, methods whose input and outputs are images. So after image enhancement, after image restoration, after image compression, after the wavelet and multi-resolution processing, though the input is image, we obtain the output as image only. And in morphological image processing, which is of both the types, and further the representation and description, the object recognition, the image segmentation, we obtain the attributes from the image. We don't obtain directly the image here, but the information content by certain parameters, we can say. So let us begin with the first fundamental step. The first fundamental step I have shown you into the block diagram, that is image acquisition here. So this is the first process. Generally, the image acquisition stage involves pre-processing such as scaling here. After this particular stage, we have the second, that is image filtering and image enhancement. This is the process of manipulating an image so that the result is more suitable than the original for a specific application here. The word specific into the first sentence is important here because it establishes at the onset that enhancement techniques are problem oriented here. Further, the example, a method that is quite useful for enhancing the X-ray images may not be the best approach for the enhancing satellite images taken into the infrared band of the electromagnetic spectrum. Hence, the word specific, the importance is shown with this particular example here. Continuing the discussion regarding the image enhancement, we have more information that there is no general theory of image enhancement, whereas the viewer of the output image is the ultimate judge whether the image enhancement technique is performing well or not. So here the enhancement techniques are so varied and use so many different image processing approaches here. Enhancement applications visually appealing, interesting and relatively simple to understand here. So after the second step, that is fundamental step, image filtering and enhancement, we have the third step, that is image restoration. Talking about the image restoration, an area that also deals with improving of the appearance of the image along with the image enhancement can be said image restoration here. However, unlike the image enhancement, which is subjective one, because we have stated that the viewer is the ultimate judge here, The image restoration is objective in the sense that the restoration techniques tend to be based on the mathematical or probabilistic models of image degradation. Now, the next fundamental step is the color image processing. Into the color image processing, we can say that an area that has been gaining the importance because of the significant increase in the use of digital images over the internet is the color image processing. The fundamental concepts of the color models we will be addressing into this particular chapter, and the basic color processing into this digital domain involves with this particular fundamental step. Also, the color is used as the basis for extracting features of the interest of the image. So this was again one more fundamental step after image enhancement and image restoration along with the image acquisition. The next fundamental step is the use of wavelets and the multi-resolution processing or multi-resolution analysis, we can say. Here I can just say that it is the foundation for representing images in various degrees of resolution, that we can say multi-resolution. In particular, this material is used for image data compression and for pyramidal representation, that means at different levels in which the images are subdivided successively into these smaller regions here. After the wavelets and multi-resolution processing, we have another fundamental step, that is image compression. Regarding the image compression, we can say that, as the name implies, it deals with the techniques for reducing the storage required to save an image or the bandwidth required to transmit it. Also, the example can be given, the JPEG file, the extension it .jpg is used into the JPEG. It stands for the Joint Photographic Experts Group image compression standard here. The next fundamental step that is belonging to both the methods of categorization. The first categorization, image is input and output, and in the second categorization, image is input, the output is attribute. So this step is morphological image processing. So in morphological image processing, we can say that it deals with the tools for extracting image components that are useful in the representation and description of the shape. So morphology basically deals with the shape here. The material begins a transition from the processes that output images to processes that output image attributes here, what we have addressed. Further, the next fundamental step is the image segmentation. We can say regarding segmentation, it is actually partitioning of the image into its constituent parts based on certain similarity constraints here. So the objects are to be partitioned into the image segmentation here. In general, the autonomous segmentation is one of the most difficult tasks into the digital image processing. A rugged segmentation procedure brings the process a long way towards the successful solution of imaging problems that require objects to be identified individually. On the other hand, weak or erratic segmentation algorithms almost always guarantee the eventual failure. And finally, here I can say that in general, the more accurate the segmentation is, the more likely recognition is to succeed. So the last fundamental step that we are going to address is object recognition, that depends on to the initial fundamental steps, especially here the image segmentation. Now, after image segmentation, we have the next step, that is into the image processing, is the representation and description. So whatever the image segmentation is giving us the output in terms of the objects, those object representations and their descriptions is to be addressed here. The first point is almost always follow the output of image segmentation, which usually is a raw pixel data. It constitutes either the boundary of a region, that is the set of pixels separating one image region from the another, or all the points into the region itself here. In either case, converting the data to a form suitable for computer processing is necessary, that is addressed by this particular fundamental step of digital image processing. The first decision that must be made is whether the data should be represented as a boundary or a complete region here, and the boundary representation is appropriate when the focus is on external shape characteristic such as the corners and inflections here. So continuing with the representation and description, we have some more information. That is, the regional representation is appropriate when the focus is on internal properties such as texture or skeletal shape. So these are details we will be getting into the more details as we start with that particular chapter. I think the chapter number 12, it is there for image representation and description. Further, we have in some applications these representations complement each other. Choosing a representation technique is only part of the solution for transforming raw data into a form suitable for subsequent computer processing. A method must also be specified for describing the data so that features of interest are highlighted here. Now the second term into the title, that is description, can be addressed. Description is also called sometimes as the feature selection here. It deals with extracting attributes that result in some quantitative information of interest or the basic of differentiating one class of objects from another. Feature in general, we can say it is the informative content from the image. So feature selection is nothing but the description here. Finally, the last fundamental step into the digital image processing is the object recognition, or simply we can say recognition here. So the process that assigns exactly a label to an object after its particular recognition, we can say, is the last step here. So it is based on to the previous one, that is descriptors. So for example, into a certain image, if a certain vehicle is there, the identification, the recognition that this is the vehicle can be done by this last step, that is the fundamental step here. So methods of recognition of individual objects are involved into this particular step. And lastly, the connection of all these fundamental steps are there with the knowledge base that we have initially shown into the block diagram. So this knowledge base can be described as a prior knowledge about a problem domain is coded into image processing system in the form of knowledge database, which is the most important thing to carry out these fundamental image processing steps. So summarizing this particular fourth video from the first chapter, we have seen image acquisition, we have seen the image enhancement, we have seen the image restoration, color image processing, wavelets, compression, morphological processing is again common to the second category. This was the first category we have addressed, along with segmentation, representation, description and recognition here. Here we can see that viewing the results of image processing can take place at the output of any stage of this fundamental digital image processing things. We can see the output. Hence the image display is not addressed here, and the very important central part, that was knowledge base here. Into the next lecture, we shall see the last part, the last video of first chapter. The chapter is introduction to digital image processing, and the topic is components of image processing system. So for getting such more topics and the details of the subject digital image processing, you can subscribe to eKida channel. Thank you.